journals have been mostly used up.
A lot of us don't like the idea of God ever being angry, but sometimes being loving means you have to get angry. Clive?
Yes?
If you see a big, mean kid picking on your little brother Ian, pushing him, making fun of him, how do you feel?
I feel angry. I want someone to stop him and make sure he doesn't do it again.
If you didn't feel angry about that, it might mean you don't love your brother very much.
But I do. I don't want to see him hurt.
Thanks, Chloe. I really appreciate that.
If you see a big bully picking on a little kid, it should make you angry. You want someone bigger and stronger to come in and set things right.
So caring about others means sometimes you're going to be angry. I guess that's true for God, too.
The story of history is filled with people acting like bullies, cheating each other, being mean to each other, even killing each other. It's not the way God wants it to be. He's been patient, holding back his anger at the evil things we do, at the meanness and selfishness in all of us, at sin and what it's done to his amazing creation.
And what John has been given is a vision of when God is going to set it all right. Give evil a spanking. Put his enemies on time out forever.
All in symbols, right?
Right, because that's how apocalyptic writing works.
Is what's in the Bible.
The story of God and what he's done for us.
The first two chapters of the Bible describe the garden God created, where Adam and Eve could live with him. The last two chapters describe the garden city, that is our ultimate destination, where God's people will live with him forever.
And chapters?
Well, why don't you guys summarize this for me?
You mean the whole rest of the Bible?
Yep.
Oh. And put Adam and Eve in a garden where they could live with him.
But they messed it up. They listened to an enemy who said, you don't want to live with God. You want to be God. And they sinned.
And sin messed up everything. They couldn't be with God anymore.
They went from being friends of God to being enemies of God. They deserved his anger.
But God didn't want to pour out his anger on the ones he loved. He wanted to fix things so we could live with him again. So he launched a rescue plan.
Through a guy named Abraham, whose children became the children of God, the Israelites.
God gave them all the rules they needed to live with him again, to be holy, set apart from the other nations.
But they couldn't do it. They just messed up over and over.
And over and over and over and over
again. You can stop.
All that messing up taught them, and us, that we can't be good enough for God, no matter how hard we try.
So since we couldn't go to God, God came to us.
Jesus, Messiah, God became one of us.
He lived the life we couldn't live, a perfect life. And then he took the punishment we deserved. He took God's anger at our evil on himself.
When Jesus died on the cross, our enemy, Satan, thought he had won. He thought death had ended Jesus. But Jesus ended Jesus won.
And the kingdom of God was planted again, like a tiny mustard seed.
We can be part of God's kingdom. We can be saved from sin by grace through faith.
By believing in Jesus and what he did on the cross.
We get new labels. Instead of sinful, God sees us as righteous.
Instead of enemies, God sees us as friends. All because of what Jesus did.
That's amazingly good news.
And Jesus told his followers to spread that good news all over the world, so people everywhere would have a chance to be a friend of God.
Which they did in the book of Acts.
And those who believed in Jesus met together in churches and were taught by people like Paul and John and James and Peter.
Who also wrote letters that help us follow Jesus even today. Epistles.
We are justified by grace through faith.
Given a new label, righteous, a friend of God.
And now that we're justified, we can be sanctified.
The Holy Spirit fills us and helps us become more like Jesus every day. More loving, kind, joyful, peaceful, patient. We are the buds, the tiny flowers of the kingdom of God.
It doesn't just happen overnight. It takes time. We have to exercise.
Spiritual disciplines. We read the Bible, the epistles, the gospels. We pray and set aside time to focus on God.
We do things together too, right?
Yeah, like being part of a church, the body of Christ.
Worshiping God together and working together to help others.
We bring the kingdom of God to life on earth. Beauty, love, justice, kindness. God's kingdom shows up through us, the church.
We know we will suffer, for we have an enemy.
The same one that lied to Adam and Eve in the garden is still lying to us today.
You don't want to follow God. You want to be God.
But we know something.
What's that?
He's a liar, and he's already lost.
That's right. Jesus settled that a long time ago.
And after Jesus comes back to end evil, to set everything right, we will live on a cloud?
No. We're living in a amazing city on a beautiful new earth without any bullies or evil, and we live with joy like the Garden of Eden knows it better.
For how long?
Forever.
Is that a happy ending or what? The world is a messy place. Spend more than a day or two here, and you're going to get hurt by someone or something. But this book tells us where that hurt comes from. Sin, rebellion, us wanting to be the ones in charge. It also tells us how we can be saved from sin by grace through faith in Jesus Christ. It tells us about the wonderful work we can do, spreading his kingdom, helping others, seeing ourselves become more and more like Jesus. And it tells us the really amazing ending, when God's kingdom bursts into full bloom. And that is what's in the Bible.
Well, sleep, sitting,
I guess we're
sitting
done.
Out long. You can,
what do we do now?
We just make a cooking show.
I wasn't cooking. I wasn't cooking.
Maybe we could eat out.
The way things are over here now, I don't think it could fall. It could have fallen without getting caught in that region. So I don't think it's over here.
Well, what about you?
I'm asleep.
I'm looking for the first DVD,
and
the way things look over here, there is too much stuff for it to fall down where I can't reach it.
Do you have any cookies?
So, either something has moved and I can't reach it, or it never fell down this way.
In the kingdom of gold, where there's no crying, there's no dying, it makes me want to applaud and say, hey, I'll get to share your invitation with everybody.
scratch off.
That must have been my fault.
Yes, it was. What are you doing now?
I think we need to look into this Kingdom of God business. Perhaps after a short nap, to strength.
And a biscuit.
A nap and a biscuit, then the Kingdom of God.
I'm with you all the way.
I don't think so.
Don't miss more fun with me and my friends at chillytilly.com.
Well, until we can really go deep over here, I don't think we're going to find it over here in your sleep.
No, this is where I think you can find it.
Yeah, because the way things are and the way the junk is falling, everything is sealed up enough to where it can't fall deep. I should have been able to reach it by now.
Don't walk away until you're awake and paying attention. It goes for you too. You look a little sleepy down there. Go get some coffee. What? You're like five? Jumping jacks. Wake up, this is important. Okay, is everyone awake?
Have some more.
Don't fall asleep and then wake up and say, oh, it's okay.